Hi everyone. So I just are you all able to hear me fine? Rahul Kumar Singh. Yep, okay. Rahul Kumar Singh, where are you from, Rahul? I'm expecting one of my friend, I think. Rahul, you are the same, if I'm guessing right. Okay, I think everyone can hear me. Actually, this is my first live that I planned. I am from Bihar. Okay, Rahul. Okay. Okay. So I started this because I sort of thought of hosting this session to public, not to any particular audience like my extended subscribers, not only to that, but to my public YouTube channel. But I face here, I had some plans for this session, like sharing some of my practical experiences in live projects and also some of the live use cases, and wanted to discuss with you so that you can also think on those use cases along with that. But I think I am facing some issue while screen sharing. I mean, I can talk to you like this for how much long I want, but while screen sharing I am facing some issues. So anyways, once I have to discuss that, I'll share some Google Meet or Geo Meet link where I can share my screen. Till that time, all of you, welcome to this first live of mine. This will be posted live, and if you have any questions, this is just regarding, like, please don't go much into each and every issues that you are going into while setting up. I have been receiving mails while setting up, I am getting this error, that error. So maybe just with the talking, I can give you some advice, but not very much in detail. So if you want that every detailed answer, so please post me on your post me on my email ID with the screenshot so that I can understand the issue. But apart from that, any verbal discussion you want to have with me, you're free to post that. Please, any topics that are very important in PySpark interview. So Tejas, it's almost same. It's not PySpark or Spark plus Scala interview, until unless you are going into specific project that is dealing with data science as well. So almost all the big data interviews, until unless Spark comes in, all the interviews are almost same. So any important topic, yes, first of all your previous experience of your project will be asked. So if you have, just mug it up like anything, and make sure all of your previous project, not only what you are doing, but you should have at least a blur idea of what your entire project, how that is how the architecture works. So that gives a good impression in front of interviewer that no matter he works on a small module, but he has at least the understanding of entire thing. And apart from that, yes, Spark and whatever language, like PySpark. So much detailed information on Python you should have, or Scala if you are going for Spark, and Scala for that matter. What are the optimization techniques in Spark real-time point of view? So yes, Prasad, Spark optimization techniques can depend upon your data point of view as well as the algorithm point of view. So in case you are handling the data that you are handling a much huge amount of data that you are not supposed to handle. So there is optimization technique at that level also. So you can optimize your data that you are handling on the daily basis. That is one of them. And second is your algorithm based. So you can optimize your code to certain level on the Spark binary and certain level on your language that you are using. So this can be done on more detail if you are using Scala, because in Scala as well, using the functional programming techniques, you can optimize to a much greater level using the correct techniques, using correct functions, using many monads in place of functions. So there are many techniques you can handle inside Scala, and many techniques you can handle using the correct APIs in Spark. So and other thing I already told, using the correct tactics or correct planning of filtering out the data that you are handling. So multiple places that can be handled. So data optimization consists of filtering out or archiving the data that you are handling. Spark optimization consists of using the correct functions. Like many people, we have seen that even when using Spark, they are using the collect and for each. So they stop using Spark then and there when they do collect and then start doing for each. So correct usage of functions like map, flat map, or filter using the correct Spark APIs, that is at Spark level. Also at Spark level, you can optimize with the correct usage of coarse memory. And furthermore on that, you can optimize using your approach in your language. Like if you are using Scala, just don't go with the object-oriented approach. Try to use some functional programming techniques as well. So that was for, I mean, as of verbally I can tell. Then I have not worked on real time. Actually, I have done training on big data technologies and done good hands-on on Spark, Scala, and other as well, and good knowledge as well. Okay. Recently, I got selected in one company. Can you help me with how to get ready for real time? You got selected. What do you want to be ready for real time? I mean, you are asking for real time data processing or something else? I'm not sure. I have seen your scenario based data videos. Those are really nice. Thank you. It would be great if you can share more. Sure. So Rahul, I am not sure if you are subscribed to the extended plan. We have been sharing lot of new use cases already in the course. We have more, so even if you are not subscribed, we'll be bringing more and more use cases on the public platform as well. So yes, we'll be coming up with that. Sir, your videos help me. Thank you. Thanks Tejas. Thanks, that means a lot. Vishal Sharma, how we migrate data from Teradata and mainframe to AWS S3, how to create pipelines. So this pipeline creation depends upon what platform you are using, first of all. And migrating data from Teradata and mainframe, you have to sync up with your upstream team. Like if your upstream is Teradata, so directly we have multiple APIs that can directly connect your big data projects like Spark framework with Teradata. So that is sort of a seamless connection. Just you have to take care of some of the infrastructure or the libraries connection that you have to make. So all the connections you can make inside your config files and Teradata, I don't think there is much challenge in that. But yes, in mainframes, yes, you will face some of the challenges. Anyways, the data from the mainframe can be pushed through any of the serial bus that your project is using. But mainframes usually have sort of different file formats that by default Spark might or might not recognize. And like for example, like IBM mainframes still produce some of the COBOL encoded data that you might not be readily able to use. So for that you have to write your custom code. So mainframe still is a big challenge, and that might be asked in many of the interviews. It's a good question that you ask, because mainframe, if I open a file that I have got from mainframe, if I open in front of you, you won't be able to understand what is that. So might be they would be a fixed width files or even the encoded files. So you have to convert it to ASCII format or ANSI format, and then after that you have to do some mapping to convert it into a data frame, understandable data frame. So that is a sort of challenge. I have a use case ready for mainframe files. Maybe if after this I go with that session, I'll share the link and you can join and you can see how we handle the mainframe files. Okay. Say something about how data validation is performed in Spark. Say something about, okay. Data validation. So that depends upon your what kind of data validation you are looking for. So usually the use cases from business we get is majorly same that I have seen in all projects, that is your null validations and your data format validations, that it is integer, a string or what. And onto that there is there can be some of your length checks. So I think data null checks, length checks, this already I have posted a video on. I think that is for only extended subscribers. Okay, I'll try to bring the use case. But if you are, I forgot your name, but if you are an extended plan subscriber, you already have the video for that. Okay, how? Okay, this is done. You are doing a great job. Thanks, Nagraj. I see very less content on Scala on internet. Even I see very less content. Why, what do you think? Like, I just get those ideas and I bring, even I try to learn from internet, and I agree with your comment, there is very less content. So even I, whatever scenarios I face, I try to post them. Thanks for that comment. How to compare data frames using subtract, except, and also joins? How to compare data frames? What comparison you need, column to column comparison, or before joining you need some data comparison? I might need some more details. How you perform incremental load in Spark? I have gone through your incremental load in Hive. Same scenario, how will you achieve in Spark? Please, okay, throw some light on that. Okay, Srinivas Samir. So first of all, if you have seen the video on Hive, so same scenario exactly can be applied in Spark SQL. So there is not much of a difference there. Then upon to that, the incremental load depends upon your columns. So in that video, if you have seen, we were getting a timestamp column as well. So according to that, you can do an incremental load, as I have told in that video. Same way you can do in Spark SQL. Now the scenario that I was telling, that there might be a chance that you might not be getting the data frame, timestamp column in that. So how are you going to consider the latest one? So in that case, you might have to use some analytical functions like rank, dense rank, and according to your given key columns, like suppose 10 columns are there, and that should have been considered while taking the incremental data. So you have to group by them and then apply the rank on that function, apply the rank on that data frame or table, And then based upon that rank, you can consider the incremental load. So depends upon what data you are getting. So if I am getting a set of data today and I am getting the set of data, same set of data tomorrow, I can consider directly the timestamp column. But scenario will completely change if I don't even have that at all. So maybe some column IDs or transaction IDs are different. So today's transaction ID is 1, and any of the transaction ID received any time after that will have something after 1. So depending upon that, you have to consider, but approach can be same. Srinivas Aditya, Harpit, I have sent you mail yesterday. Please once check. Srinivas Aditya, I think you should check your mail first, because a couple of hours back I have already replied. Thanks. Okay. Pawan Kumar, how to do null validation check in Spark? I already have posted the video, but bad thing is only the extended plan subscribers have it. Anyways, Ramagiri, if you have only this concern, not the entire one, please send me, ping me on WhatsApp or ping me on my email ID. Only if this is your concern, I'll surely share the code with you. Sarang Joshi in PySpark, how to move your code from different environments like dev et. What is et? Okay, anyways, I got the context. Et to prod, just 1 minute. So Sarang, it's not only for PySpark, but also for all other environments, sorry, all other programming languages, and even not only for Spark and Scala and Big Data, any programming language, any production level project, the process is almost same. So how do we work is, let's say we got a requirement, we developed something, and we wrote the test cases, we tested the code. So this everything, how we do, we don't have anything as of now. Suppose a new requirement comes, so we pull the code, or we pull any of the reference branches in any of the VCS system like GitHub. So we pull it, make our changes. Usually requirements, these days everyone is using Agile. So let's say we are using Jira. So in Jira, how we get is, these requirements are broken into stories. So what we do, we pull the reference code and we make a feature branch, that we call it. So we make a feature branch out of that code, and we make all those changes according to the requirement. Suppose you got one requirement that I have to add 4 new columns. Let's say these are a metadata. So when the record arrived, we have to generate a time and some unique ID. So let's suppose 2 columns. So this is your functionality. You will pull the code and you will create a feature branch and you will implement all this. And this is in your dev environment. Then what you will do, maybe your team lead will review it, and once that is all finalized, you will push that for review. Maybe your team lead, once he reviews, finally, if everything is approved, that will be merged to the main branch of dev. Okay, then that code will go to your quality analysis, and then finally, the same in your same code branch, there will be a production branch. So that code will be directly merged to the to your production branch. In case anyone else has worked on that same piece of code, you might get some conflict. So that will be resolved by your team lead, or maybe some team will sit together, you and your team lead and your scrum master. Everyone will sit together, and those conflicts will be resolved, that you made this change, this is not required, this is the latest, all those things. And finally, your code will be merged to the next level of branch, that you can say as your testing or your production. So that's how it works. Now what we have, Uzi. Okay, that's how, I'm not repeating, that's how he wrote it. He Sachin, उसी वन सेशन ओनली आई हैव प्रोवाइडेड. आफ्टर दैट आई कुड मेक मोर, बट आई स्विच टू एयर फ्लो नॉट ओनली फॉर माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग बट दैट प्रोजेक्ट आई वॉज यूजिंग. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट मोर ऑन दैट आई नीड सम टाइम बिकॉज आई वी आर नॉट यूजिंग उजी एनी मोर. इफ यू आर यूजिंग लाइक इट विल टेक सम टाइम, बट वी आर यूजिंग एयर फ्लो एंड एज्योर रन बुक्स एंड मेनी अदर टूल्स फॉर शेड्यूलिंग. सो ओके, आई मीन आई कैन से सॉरी यू फॉर दैट. I'll try to bring up soon. Okay, any course on Kafka with Spark? Course, Shah Alam, not complete course, but yes, what best I could do, there are some videos on my channel to go through that. How many use cases big data project will have? How many use cases? Okay, like one requirement is one use case. Or one requirement can have multiple use case. Okay, so this is how it works. It's not one requirement. Use cases can be multiple, but this depends upon different functionality depending upon your domain. Suppose you are into the sales domain, and they are launching some new feature or like a simple website, like a Flipkart, you can understand. They are launching, what do you say, suggestions they already have. Let's suppose they are launching along with the MasterCard, they are also accepting RuPay card that is prevalent in India. So this could be your, as per company, this is a use case, but this will be delivered to us as entire requirement. So this will be given to us as you can say a complete requirement, and if depending upon your what model you are using in your development company, like if you're using Agile, so maybe this complete thing will be broken up into different stories. Suppose there are many things that can be done here, that getting the detail of the cards, how by first four digits you can understand what kind of card it is. You won't understand yourself. You have to integrate some upstream API that will tell you this is a MasterCard, RuPay card or what. Then coming to that, then integration with connection to your banking API that will confirm your CVV code with that. So that will be another module. So different kind of module will be there. But this will be given to you as a one requirement. Now, what your company will do, that will break those all requirements into, let's say, 100 different kind of stories. Stories is just like a small module of that, you can understand. So stories are really small. So even one person can finish in 2 3 days one story, but there will be hundreds of them. Then they will plan like this. These are the 100 stories. How we are going to plan this RuPay card functionality will implement in suppose 3 months or 2 months, I mean depending upon the resources I'm telling. So they will collect those 10 10 10 stories into different sprints. That is called a sprint in Agile. That is, I'm talking about Agile because that is the most of the companies are using, so you will be facing this thing. So let's a sprint is almost about 2 weeks. So in that, those 10 stories will be divided into multiple developers, and those will be given to them that this is a requirement, this is the requirement. They will understand it and they will start building small small modules. And once this 2 week sprint is done, and in the big in mid, I mean between of those sprints, the code is developed, tested by QA, rejected, again modifications are done. So it's like a cycle in each sprint. Once each sprint is done, this code is posted, tested, and again after 2 weeks, next sprint is done. So it's almost like 3 months, all the functionalities that is done. So after each sprint, when the final code is posted to your production branch, so final functionality gets ready. So that is how a functionality like you asked, that use cases will have more than one requirement. So requirement is big,
But yes, use cases, small use cases are worked this way in sprints and stories. So if that answers your question. Sir, explain more about repartition with Ria. Okay. Repartition coalesce. Yeah, small definition I have already given, but okay, with a real time scenario, I'll try to make a video. Just similar, like a small idea you can have. Coalesce, just use it whenever you have to reduce number of partitions, and not optimal every time, but yes, you have an option. And repartition depends totally upon your ability to optimize the code. So don't use repartition until you are not sure. So this can even increase your number of partition or decrease your number of partition. Verbally, I can tell that much, but for a live scenario, I will gather some huge data set, some at least 5 to 10 GB that I can show you, but that I need some data to explain. If you have some data, then let me know. Otherwise, I'll gather. Can you please make some video of Kafka streams? Harpreet Kaur, yes, Kafka stream. So in my extended plan, I have already mentioned Kafka, and first of all, I'm on to working for the Azure platform. Detailed video, like for AWS, I have already mentioned how to create cluster, post the jobs, running the jobs. Next plan is for Azure, as I have already told, but it's taking time. And Kafka is also one of the topics. So Harpreet, yes, I'll be bringing them soon. Tejas, please let me know what is new in Spark 3 from interview perspective. Lot of things. I don't remember the names exactly, but yes, dynamic allocation is there. More onto that, like one of you have asked for the binary files reading. So in Spark 3.0, any of the mainframe files that I have seen, any of the mainframe files that we struggle to read in any version before 3, can be directly read into Spark data frames now. So mainframe files, like you have some gibberish and you have to read something and convert line by line, and you cannot read it in data frames. I mean, that there is no option. But in Spark 3.0, there is an option that directly from the mainframes you can load the data into your data frames. It will automatically convert everything. That is very good. And these are the small things. Spark 3.0 documentation will have all the details, 90% of which you won't understand that why it is useful. But for now, if you are giving interviews, just make note of three four points. Because these are very detailed, because these are very, you can say, algorithm based. So even if you get that, you won't be, what do you say, you won't be estimating the benefit of that until you apply it. That what is good in that, just with the functions you cannot analyze. So go with the 3 4 points and make note that this is new, and if that is a part of your interview questions. Few of the point I already told. The binary file one that helped me a lot. Deepatro, hi sir. Hi Deepatro. Sachin, Uzi, Uzi. Sachin is stuck to Uzi. Sachin is stuck to Uzi. I think I have to make the video for Sachin. Sachin, I'm really sorry. Yes, I'll bring up that soon. Which is good to learn, PySpark or Scala with Spark? I've discussed it earlier. If you are moving into data engineering only, then please go with Scala and Spark, because in Scala and Spark, people once they deep dive, they think that they are sort of isolated from the society because no one is talking about Scala. But yes, if you understand the basics of Scala, you will start loving the programming, not the programming languages. That's what I can say. So if you want to love programming, want to love at least, Then go with Scala. There are many deep things. See, Python makes the work easy. That is the best thing that anyone can do in 2020. If anything makes your work easy, that is always preferred. So that is why Python is preferred. But from the knowledge perspective and from the data engineering perspective, if you are inclined towards that, Scala is the way to go. You'll learn many more things that may be not trending, but that will give you much more confidence that you know too much of programming. So Scala in that case, so it depends upon your choice. Can we maintain code repository for Spark in real time? I didn't get Anil. Maintain code for repository. Yes, we can. Is it regarding the GitHub repository or please elaborate? I mean, yes, we can in GitHub or any VCS. Saisri, how to validate data after migrating from RDBMS to Hadoop apart from scope validation threshold? Any? I didn't get that question. So, apart from scope validation threshold, so if you have the data in Hadoop, I believe that is in HDFS. So, what's stopping you to validate? I didn't get your question. You can start picking up from HDFS and validate. Do you work on Azure, Anshul? Do you work on Azure also? Not much, but I have worked on Azure Cloud to the limit that I have deployed the code on Azure, saved all of my files in all three types of systems. So Azure has more or less three types of storage: ADLS, that is Azure Data Lake, Blob, and file system storage. So all those storage I have handled, and for scheduling as well, Azure runbooks that are coded in, that can be coded in Python, PowerShell. So yes, almost all infrastructure I have touched, but not exactly into deep into Azure. And I don't think any big data developer would do that. That is for Azure developer or infrastructure admin or something. But yes, as a part of developer, I have touched most things that anyone can do as a developer. Which is good, Kafka, Java, huh? Kafka with Java or okay, Kafka with Java or Scala, both are equally fine. So when it comes with integration of Kafka with Spark, then it has readily all APIs in Scala as well. Anyways, in Scala as well, you can use the Java APIs, but Java libraries. But when you are dealing with Spark, then mostly people use Scala. And other way, if it is not Spark with Kafka, you can use Java. So you should not be confused in Kafka with Java or Scala, because both run on JVM and with slightly perform, there is high negligible performance issue. So with Java, the code developer community is bigger. So you get the leverage on that easily people are available to develop the code. In Scala, if developer community is small, then developing code is also easier if you have a skilled Scala developer. That's it. Anything you can. Saurav Das, Anshul, can I connect with you, bro? Okay, yeah, that's good if we can connect with each other if you have similar kind of issues. Sarang Joshi, 20,000. How can I split delimiter in case of salary as well? Who are you asking? How can I? Okay, one Sarang Joshi, 20,000. Okay. How can I split it having delimiter comma in case of salary as well? Okay, then in this case you have to use the regular expression in Sara. So regular expression you can design that ignores the last delimiter. So last delimiter will be on your salary and that will be ignored. So that's simple. Please, okay. Tell me, people are talking among themselves. Good. भाई आप मेरे गुरु हो, कंपनी में कोई हेल्प नहीं करता। सचिन, अरे हिंदी में बात कर। गुड। अरे नहीं, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है यार, गुरु की बात नहीं है। व्हाट एवर बेस्ट आई कैन डिलीवर आई विल ऑलवेज डू। इट्स नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम। जस्ट इशू समटाइम्स इज दैट पीपल आस्क मी क्वेश्चन विदाउट इवन लाइक इवन फॉर माई सब्सक्राइबर्स लाइक एक्सटेंडेड प्लान सब्सक्राइबर्स एवरी वन आई एम टेलिंग दिस दैट इफ यू फेस सम इशू इवन देन इवन दैट आई हैव टोल्ड इन माई कोड दैट दिस इज हाउ इट वर्क्स यू माइट फेस लाइक अकॉर्डिंग टू योर सिस्टम सेटअप यू माइट फेस सम ऑड टाइम यू माइट फेस सम ऑफ द इशूज यू पीपल डोंट इवन केयर टू गूगल इट और एटलीस्ट डू सम रिसर्च जस्ट डायरेक्टली दे हैव एन ऑप्शन दे कैन दे सेंड मी अ मेल जस्ट आई मीन आई सी दैट एंड रिप्लाई बट इट माइट वेस्ट योर कपल ऑफ आवर्स और कपल ऑफ डेज फॉर दैट मैटर सो जस्ट लेट मी नो इफ यू हैव अ जेन्युइन प्रॉब्लम आई एम ऑलवेज रेडी टू हेल्प वाई स्कूप स्टिल नेसेसरी वी कैन रीड आर डी बी एम एस यूजिंग स्पार्क टू स्टोर इन एच डी एफ एस येस हु टोल्ड यू स्कूप इज नेसेसरी स्कूप इज नॉट नेसेसरी बट इट कैन नॉट बी इग्नोर्ड हु आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन गिरीश गिरीश अंडरस्टैंड दिस इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी फॉर यू दैट्स फाइन बट इन एनी लाइव प्रोजेक्ट यू नो डेटा इज नॉट डिलीवर्ड टू यू डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम दी जन आई मीन सोर्स पॉइंट सो ऑलरेडी इन योर प्रोजेक्ट देर आर मल्टीपल टीम्स इन्वॉल्व इन दैट मे बी देर इज सम टीम दैट इज ओनली डिजाइंड और आई मीन डिप्लॉयड देयर जस्ट टू टेक द डेटा एंड डिलीवर टू द बिग डेटा पाइपलाइन इन विच यू आर देयर जस्ट सपोज सो दे डोंट हैव एनीथिंग लाइक स्पार्क और समथिंग दे डोंट हैव नॉलेज ऑन दैट सो फॉर देयर डेटा यू कैन से डेटा इंजेशन टीम लेट्स गिव इट अ नेम सो दे हैव द ऑप्शन फॉर लिमिटेड टूल्स लाइक स्कोप एंड ऑल सो दैट इन टर्न मेक्स योर वर्क इजी दैट यू आर गेटिंग द चंक्ड आउट डेटा एंड फिल्टर्ड डेटा दैट यू हैव टू प्रोसेस सो इट्स इजी वर्क फॉर यू एंड फ्रॉम देयर साइड दे डोंट हैव टू हैव अ नॉलेज ऑन स्पार्क एंड ऑल सो फॉर यू येस यू डोंट नीड स्कोप इफ यू आर डूइंग एनी प्रोजेक्ट विच डजेंट हैव मल्टीपल हायरार्कीज इन टीम इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी फॉर यू बट इफ इट इज दैट यू मे बी यू आर डायरेक्टली रीडिंग इन टू स्पार्क बट यू नेवर नो द डेटा दैट यू आर रीडिंग इन टू स्पार्क दैट माइट बी डिलीवर्ड टू यू यूजिंग स्कोप फ्रॉम सम ऑफ द अपस्ट्रीम टीम सो दैट कैन हैपन यू माइट नॉट नीड स्कोप दैट्स फाइन If someone has 7 years total experience and willing to switch to big data, so based upon the knowledge he will have from the training, how much relevant experience can he show in? Okay, how much relevant experience? So that depends upon how much you get from that course. If you get exactly what is supposed to be delivered in that course if you get exactly that into depth and you have seen all those videos implemented on your own then I must tell you that even after 7 years of complete big data experience many people don't have that knowledge so they just build some kind of code just throw it away post it commit it and they don't have all those knowledge so that depends upon how deep you learn Apart from that, for beginning with that course, just a small idea you should have in Spark that I think if you are trying to move to big data after 7 years that you might have gathered already. Try to gather some of the knowledge on Spark and after that, yes, all that knowledge is given in that. Also in the extended plan, I have given some related to AWS and Hive, HDFS, interview questions, and Scala best practices, and 4 or 5 updates are also there till now. More will be coming. So that is, I'm making them with the same mindset that what is the exact thing then that any developer should have the knowledge of. Bhai, thank you. Bhai, thanks. Bhai, thanks. Bhai, thanks. Okay, Sachin, thanks. NB, ETL, Glue, EMR, Spark, Python in Glue for nested JSON. NB, frankly telling, I have worked on EMR, ETL, like that is the flow that we have done. But Glue, in very deep, I will be making video, but as of now, I cannot comment on that. So ETL, I think it's different domain things that you are comparing in Spark or Python. Can you elaborate or send me on mail? Because I don't think EMR, ETL, Glue can be compared apples to apples. Why scoops? Okay. So this is done. What is extend? Oh, Pawan. What is extended subscribe? Pawan, if you go to my channel, we are also providing the complete end-to-end big data course. So that is available in PySpark and Spark and Scala. So that has two variants, starter and extended. So you can go through those videos or visit the courses tab in my website, gkcodelabs.com. So there you will get all the details. If some... How to do data ingestion using Unix scripting using HPSA and connect to HPSA. Am I missing? What is the abbreviation for HPSA? Ingestion using Unix scripting. Yeah, that can be done, but for big data, just don't give every load on your Linux server. If possible, please make a video. Okay. Yeah. Vishal, just let me know what is HPSA you are exactly talking about. I have been asked in one of the interviews that what Python library Saran, you have been asked that what Python library you use in Spark. You use Spark library, whatever. Just this much you have been asked. What Python library you use in Spark? So, okay. The other way around. It might be the intention might be other way around. That in Spark, in PySpark, you while using Spark, what other libraries of Python you use? So that depends upon your requirement. Like, let's suppose for reading of any configurations, there would be different libraries and. There is a config parser libraries and one could be for your string data manipulation. Many different libraries are there that is only related to Python. But make sure on Spark distributed data, you cannot apply them. So if you have some small requirements, like I have already explained this in my courses. That let's say suppose you are hard coding some values and you don't want to do that and you have to read those values from the config file. So this is a not a big data requirement, just a config file you have to read from some other location. So in that your multiple third party libraries, Python libraries can be used like config parser and also such kind of different requirement base can be used. Parul Sharma. Sir, I have good knowledge of Python MLDL. Now I want to learn big data also. So with which language should I learn big data? PySpark or Scala? No, if you have good, but first question, if you have good knowledge on Python MLDL, why are you coming into big data? First thing, we should go into data engineering, do some TensorFlow, do some Keras, and still if you want that, fine. PySpark will be very easy for you.
Yogeshwaran, I have subscribed to extended plan Occupy Spark, not getting many videos on it. I think, shall I need to subscribe? No, no, you don't need. If you are onto PySpark, I think already 5 to 6 updates are already pushed. Can you check if even if you have not got the mails, just check your email ID. You should be having the links. So I don't know, you are talking about the use cases. Because in PySpark as well, if I remember, you should be getting, like, I'm committing right now, that complete 5-hour course, then an Hive and HBase session, complete AWS session, which includes creating the cluster, deploying the application, everything. And you should have one dynamic data validation, and you should have one live streaming scenario. I don't know why you are saying that you have not been getting updates. If any one of which I have talked, you have not got, just let me know. Scoop is used for RDBMS data. Scoop is used for RDBMS data. Then what for unstructured data? So unstructured data, Sachin, this is usually, obviously in RDBMS that cannot be pushed, because before that also it needs processing. So this is for these kind of scenario only, big data or Spark comes in. So these kind of data are directly pushed into your data lakes. That can be your distributed storage like S3 or Azure Data Lake, ADLS. So some distributed storage is directly pushed into that. And frameworks like Spark comes into play that time. They read it, understand it, and transform it. I have till December validity for extended plan. Can I extend it nominal fee to keep in touch? Yeah, sure. I haven't planned it as of now, but yes, if people are interested in having such knowledge, I'll surely extend it. Even I was planning to make like whatever complete end-to-end big data pipeline I have posted. So people are liking that. I think they are covering and coding according to that. But I have one complete big data pipeline that that is based. This was a complete, real time scenario only. But it's a hypothetical thing, but based upon real scenarios. So I have a complete end to end pipeline again, but that is actual real scenario. If you can say so, that also I am trying to bring up. So if it comes by December, January, it's fine. Otherwise, I'll keep you posted. If you're interested in that, you can continue this session. Otherwise, up to you. HSPA is used to bring entire server, both physical management, gainful. It's kind of some serial bus, I think, right, Vishal? Okay, at least give me its full form, HPSA. Sir, how important is to learn cloud computing with big data Parul? Yes, it's pretty important, because all the pipelines will be doing that. Will be implementing some or the other cloud platform. So maybe they don't need actually you to work on that, but yes, basically few components in that maybe you have to handle as a developer. Maybe after developing your code, you have to schedule into some of the cloud platform, or maybe while developing your code you have to read and write data into some cloud platform storage. So they prefer that at least you should have the knowledge on that. So it is important, not in very deep as a developer, but every cloud platform has some kind of storage. So if nothing at all, just understand the storages of every cloud platform. What is the storage forms in AWS? What are the storage forms in big data cloud platforms in Azure and GCP? So that is most important. Other part, you can, if you have understood, you can make it up. Which scheduler is better, Uzi or Apache Airflow? Sai Lila, it's Apache Airflow as of now, because first of all, it's trending. What grows in market, that's most preferred. And out of these, I'm telling, not the best, I'm telling. Apache Airflow is not the best thing to go with, but out of these, yes. Uzi is a bit complicated to work with, and Apache Airflow is easy. Sarang Joshi, Log4j for what? Log4j, yes, but for what? Just Log4j question mark. HP server automation. Okay, HP server automation. So this is very specific, Vishal. So it's not very general thing, but let me know what help you need. I don't think I have worked on this. Is there a way to rename part 005? Part 005. Good question. I have to search on this. For rename, like the extensions, obviously you can rename ORC, Parquet, Text, but for rename, good question. I'll search on this, Naveen. Even I'm not aware. Just the number of files you can manipulate depending upon your executors and the extensions you can manipulate. But part 00, you can manipulate if you are doing a coalesce and finally writing it to one file. That time you can manipulate. But if you are saying that 5, 10 part files are there, and I want to name like Naveen 1, Naveen 2, Naveen 3, that I have to search. That is pretty a unique requirement. I'll search, but this is a good question. Thanks. I want to learn MLlib. Can you recommend some course for it? Anshul, MLlib, as of now, not any specific, but yeah, you can go with the courses with Edureka and Coursera. Not any specific. If it comes, I might be telling, but I don't want to give you a wrong impression. I'm not, I cannot suggest you like this is the best, but yes, the courses are there. I think you are already aware. Just grab the knowledge, go into that, and you'll get more details like what resources are best. Sachin bhai, why you use Scope if everything can be done with Spark? Sachin, I already answered this in this same session. So just a small recall that yes, you can do everything in Spark and you need not use Scope. But maybe in some different hierarchy in your project, Scope will be used. So it's fine. It's not mandatory to use Scope. Anyways, this will be there on YouTube, so you can see I have already answered this. Please make use case that merging two data frames having nested columns. Inside nested column for both data frames, columns are different. Okay, so which are missing from this should be added as a null. Looks like a join condition, normal, but can you give me a small description on this? Because verbally I cannot tell, but yes, the requirement if you can give. Vamsi Krishna, I think you are already my extended plan subscriber, so mail me on that, I'll answer it. Please make videos on GitHub or any code repository for maintaining Spark code. Okay. Anil. Okay. Yeah, I'm maintaining them in my Git repo, private repositories. For those all branching techniques and packaging techniques, I'll bring this up. Also, I think branching and all, Anil, if you have seen this live session from starting, I have answered that in one of the questions. So how we get the requirement, how we create the feature branches, how we merge them, this I have already discussed. So if you
were not the part of this live stream since then. So once this is posted on YouTube, you can go through that. If you could also continue further than December, we'll include more projects until the sections. I'll surely update everyone. What is the difference between executor and executor core? So executor is your logical thing that deploys the tasks, and the physical resources that are available for that executor, that logical entity to execute all the tasks, that is the executor core. So you can see one person, you can understand one person or entity that can be assigned different tasks, and whatever physical cores are assigned to that person, let 5 cores are assigned to you, you can give to your task and do this all operations that are the executor cores. For Scala, any good courses on Udemy? Yes, there are any Scala specifically. I think there is good session with I think you already know his name, D. Gadi Raju, Durga Gadi Raju. His session is very good, and there are multiple other you can see according to the ratings, there are good sessions. Even I got a chance to talk with him, Durga. So he is in US. One time I got on WhatsApp call with him, so it was very nice talking to him. So Durga, if you are watching this video, I think that was a good conversation, and it was really nice talking to you. भाई आपको कितना टाइम लगा बिग डेटा में होल्ड ग्रैब करने के लिए? सचिन भाई अभी तक ग्रैब ही कर रहे हैं, लर्निंग का कोई लिमिट तो है नहीं. बट अभी देखो तो एटलीस्ट 3 साल तो लगा अभी तक, मतलब मैं बता रहा हूँ. बट इफ एनीवन वांट्स टू गेट टू सर्टेन लिमिट, 1 ईयर इज इनफ. 1 मैक्स, 1 इज मैक्स टू गेट स्टार्टेड विद इट. आई डोंट थिंक मोर देन दैट. 1-2 साल में तो आईएएस की तैयारी हो जाती है यार, ये तो बिग डेटा है. बेस्ट वे टू एक्सेस नेस्टेड जेएसएन, नवीन वन वे फ्लैटेंड और एक्सप्लोडेड. नवीन एट 12:15 डोंट आस्क मी द कोडिंग क्वेश्चंस. इफ आई मे से जस्ट लेट मी नो, जस्ट गिव द सिनेरियो, बिकॉज आई ऑलवेज कैन सॉल्व दीज काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. बट लेट मी, बेस्ट वे टू एक्सेस नेस्टेड जेएसएन complex data type, one way is to flatten by explode function or by any other way. It's JSON, Naveen. If you are using Spark, you can write it directly, read it as JSON into data frame, then do whatever you want, if that answers your question. But don't ask me the coding specific use case basic question. But this one you can do in data frame. AWS with big data, can you please create content? AWS with big data, Hitesh, I have already done. Sorry to say again, for extended plan subscribers, I have already there is still another video on not very detailed, but there is another AWS EMR cluster specifically, what is it, how we use it, what is this actually is, on my channel. So you can go and see that on entire thing, that how that is created, how that is connected to all, is in my extended plan, AWS EMR with Spark, Hitesh. Yes, that is there. Around 10-15 minutes session is on my public YouTube channel, other part is the extended version. What is incremental full append merge ingestion? Abhishek, what is this? What is incremental slash full slash append slash append merge ingestion? That is answering in the words itself. Incremental is understanding the data that might have updates in the next batch, Like today you got some data, next day you got similar kind of data that you have to aggregate or update. Full is flush and fill. And once the next day data comes, that will flush it. Append will already append it. So today you got one sale for a product A. Second day you got sale for same product of amount B. So append will have product of sale, same product as A and B. So nothing will be computed. Append merge, what is this? Append merge, not really sure. Where are you getting this? Let me know. Is it possible to watch video without downloading? Yes, it is. Yeah. No, it's not. Because the content I'm providing is in zip files. So I don't think directly you can unzip and watch them. But individual videos only you can watch. But why do you want to do that? NB. NB is your name, but why do you want to do that? Even if you watch it, how much data you are going to save? How to tackle manager industry level stuff? Manager industry? How to tackle manager? First question. Industry level stuff. Oh. How to tackle manager? Don't listen to him. Thanks for answering all questions. Your inputs are really very helpful. Thanks, Kiran. Thanks. Sachin, don't listen to your manager. Tell him what you want to do. CCA 175 certification is useful for Hadoop-based job. No, not at all. That's all for your confidence, your knowledge, everything up to you. Like, you want to have confidence, you want to see it, and CCA 175 certified. Yes, you can go. I'm not saying don't do it. Do it. Do whatever. Do it. CCA 175. Do Databricks certification. Do whatever you want. It's better. Do it three times. That should develop your knowledge, your confidence. In that case, yes, do it. But for job, if you think that is necessary or not, no, it's not necessary. Useful for this course. Vamsi Krishna, मानोगे नहीं है तो फिर एक question. DF1 ID person name क्या है यार, बहुत पास में जाना है. ID person 1, okay. DF2 ID person 2 DT. This is a good data frame. What you want us to do with this? He just posted a data frame. Please post this question not on. Do you think it's good to ask the live data frame and queries in the live session? But yes, I'm not saying I'll not answer, but as of now I can only see the data frame. I'll answer, let me know on my mail ID. Could you please tell me a simple use case of Scoop Hybase Spark integration? Omkar. Use case of Scoop Hive HBase by Spark. Use case, it's in front of you, man. There is a data lying in either your database, like Oracle database, SQL database, anywhere. You have to gather the specific data, let's say of any particular month. You have to gather that and store it in your Hive. Then maybe some operations or transformations you have to do, that you will do using PySpark. And finally, you can persist that into HBase. So Hive HBase, just divide that Hive PySpark HBase. That is usually done. Sidhu, मैं बोल रहा industry level stuff net पे नहीं मिलता. हाँ भाई, नहीं मिलता. सही बात है. ये तो experience करना पड़ता है. Your course take more times to download. अभिषेक कुमार. ओके, आई कैन नॉट हेल्प इन दैट बिकॉज गूगल सर्वर इज बिहाइंड दैट. सो मे बी जस्ट चेक एंड रीस्टार्ट योर राउटर, चेक योर स्पीड, नेट नेट कनेक्शन. डोंट डाउनलोड यूजिंग एनी वीपीएन. आई वुड से वीपीएन कुड बी स्लो एंड चेक योर नेटवर्क कनेक्शन. दैट्स इट. इट्स नॉट माई सर्वर एंड इफ यू बिलीव गूगल यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड. गूगल सर्वर शुड नॉट बी स्लो. बट एनी वेज, इफ यू आर एबल टू डाउनलोड डी एंड लेट मी नो. इफ यू स्टिल फेस एनी इशू ऑल्सो लेट मी नो. आई डोंट वॉन्ट यू टू नॉट डाउनलोड इट. आईडी पर्सन आर कॉलम नेम्स वमसी. ओके, गेट बैक टू मी ऑन माई मेल आईडी. भाई मज़ा आ गया आपको लाइव सेशन देखा. सुबह ऑफिस जाना है. बाय बाय, गुड नाइट. हाँ भाई, मुझे भी सुबह काम करना है. ओके, सो इफ दैट इज़ ऑल, इफ एनीवन हैज़ एनी क्वेश्चन वील वेट फॉर 1 or 2 minutes. अदरवाइज इट वॉज अ नाइस सेशन. लेट अस लॉग ऑफ. हैव अ टाइट स्लीप. मोहित, यस आई एग्री विथ अभिषेक. कैन वी एक्सेप्ट मोर ऑनलाइन वीडियोज़ ऑन योर वेबसाइट एज अ कोर्स? यस मोहित, इफ इट इज़ रिगार्डिंग द यूज केसेस, यस मोर विल बी कमिंग. क्लाउड बेस्ड आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड दैट विल बी कमिंग, सो जस्ट वेट, इट विल बी कमिंग. नवीन, डेटा रीड फ्रॉम डेटा सोर्स लाइक एसक्यूएल स्टोर्ड इन डीबी. क्वेरिंग बेस्ट क्वेरिंग डायरेक्टली. डेटा रीड फ्रॉम डेटा सोर्स लाइक एसक्यूएल इनटू डेटा फ्रेम एंड क्वेरिंग इट रिपीटेडली इज बेस्ट क्वेरिंग इट डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम डेटा सोर्सेस. यस, सो या दैट्स वाई बेसिकली एवरीथिंग इज थ्रोन इन टू डेटा लेक्स सो दैट इट्स नॉट रिपीटेड इंटरैक्शंस विद RDBMS. दोबारा लाइव कब से आ रहे आप? सचिन भाई, कोई प्लान नहीं है, बट जब भी आऊँगा बता दूंगा. थैंक्स फॉर लाइव सेशन. यू आर डूइंग गुड वर्क. थैंक यू. थैंक्स थैंक्स एवरीवन. थैंक्स. गुड नाइट. टेक केयर. बाय बाय.